We are going to discuss about the police raid on Jimmy Minor Wanjigi's home. There's a reason for it. And he was, the reason was that he is a financier of Nane Nane. There was even rumors within the security apparatus in the last few days that he was holding a meeting with Eric Omondi and a few other people on financing of the Nane Nane. That is Jimmy Minor Wanjigi. Now, why, how comes that he reaches a stage that he starts using his billions in such an endeavor? Maybe if you understood his background. He took over a business. He's the CEO of Kwacha Company. This company was started by his father, and he took over and expanded it exceedingly. We have some people who start a business enterprise, but somebody else takes it over, and whoever takes it over usually develop it more than even the founder. A quick reminder is Equity Bank. Equity Bank was started by Munga, but Dr. James came and took it over and extended it and overshadowed Munga. Just the way Jimmy Wanjigi took over Kwacha and extended it and overshadowed his father. But then, it is very hard to have a business without an underhand world. I want to divide into three his life in politics. You know, in politics, even in the US, we have wananchi and we have wenye inchi. Wenye inchi, just look at the governor, look at the president, look at the budgets that they conduct for them to be elected. Very little is their money. Because if you look at what they are campaigning, they use a lot of money. We have financiers who finance these projects, and it is these financiers who decide things the way they are. Now, Jimmy Wanjigi was a financier of one George Kinuthia Saitoti. George Kinuthia Muthengi Saitoti. But when Saitoti died, and I want to make it clear that Saitoti was killed by drug barons, not politicians in Kenya, drug barons, international drug barons. Then he was hanging. Then when he was hanging, he had nobody he could support. So the nearest person was Uhuru Muigai Kenyatta. Yeye ndiye aliwapanga. Yeye ndiye aliwapanga. He's the one who brought up that lineup. You know, Uhuru and Ruto, there was no way they could work together. Of course, there was also the ICC case, but even the local area, he is the one who financed their campaign. And when he financed their campaign, imagine a person like him financing a Jomo Kenyatta family member. He's very rich. So it reached a stage where he didn't like the lineup. Actually, the lineup was four people. There was Uhuru Muigai Kenyatta. There was Ruto. There was Mudavadi. And there was Kalonzo Musyoka. But he didn't like some of them. So he went and told. And you see, Kalonzo Musyoka also misspoke. He misspoke by trying to tell them not to be worried. He will only rule for a short time, and when they are through with the ICC cases, he can hand over power to them. Mudavadi would have taken this thing, but for reasons not known to anybody else apart from Jimmy Wanjigi, Jimmy Wanjigi just called Ruto and Uhuru and told them that they should know how. Mutajua vile mutaambia how. mtajua vile mtaambia hawa, we don't want them. And that is how Uhuru was very nervous and even over smoking when they were in the gazebo, when they were in the gazebo kwa Kalonzo Musyoka, because it was, they were supposed to tell Kalonzo that he's not on the ballot paper. The financier has not accepted. Then from there, there is a Mudavadi, you know, he used to tell mutu wa pesa, he just tell them, know how you will tell so and so that is not on the ballot. Just tell him he's not on the ballot paper. That is what is important. And you know how you'll tell them. And that is how Uhuru came up and said, ndio ekole angoma ishishia umire. Nikikuyu saying, we don't know where this madimoni came from. That is the origin of the word madimoni. Now, Wanjigi's plan was that, you see, you will notice that once Jubilee took over, when Jubilee coalition took over, the agreed price for SGR from Mombasa to Nairobi was altered upwards. It was altered upwards because the new boys, in the people who financed for the campaign wanted their money. They wanted their money. So it had to be changed. And you know, before Saitoti died, when Jimmy Wanjigi was with Saitoti, he was guaranteed that SGR, he is the one to. You know, you have to have a local company which wins the contract. Just like, for example, there's a bridge they are going to construct. So I win the contract of so much millions of shillings. Then I look for a proper construction company and tell them, I've won a contract of 7 million shillings. How much will you take? So they take it either 6 or 5.5. Zajuu ni zangu. And that is how the plans are. So Wanjigi had agreed with Saitoti that if Saitoti was to be the president, Wanjigi would. But then Saitoti died. So Wanjigi went to Uhuru Muigai Kenyatta and Ruto and said he wanted the SGR to Nairobi, from Mombasa to Nairobi. But when he didn't get it, he started bringing problems using other people. He started using other people. He started using Keter and Jacob Juma. He started using Keter and Jacob Juma. And one day while they were at Eldoret, Uhuru told Keter, you go and tell your boss not to worry. The SGR from Nairobi, from Mombasa to Nairobi, has been taken. Phase two from Nairobi to Kisumu is free. He can always take it, but you see, you cannot wait for that. And then Jimmy Wanjigi entered into a situation where he took my former alumni Jacob Juma to be his troubleshooter. But then Jimmy Wanjigi is the one who killed Jacob Juma. Because you say, so and so, you say Ruto will kill me, and then you say Ruto will kill me, and then when you say Ruto will kill me, somebody else kills you, so as Ruto is blamed. Now, immediately after, okay, before I continue there, if you want to know why Jacob Juma was killed by Jimmy Wanjigi, is that within hours of Jacob Juma's body being discovered, Jimmy Wanjigi ordered for a very expensive coffin from London. And he also went to Jacob Juma's widow, who is a Kikuyu, and took very important documents and stuck to them. So it is after Nani's death, it was after Jimmy Wanjigi's death, not Jimmy Wanjigi, Jacob Juma's death, that Jimmy Wanjigi realized that instead of using other people to go and fight my fights, let me now be on the forefront. And that is why he is that way. And that is why he has even now was financing the Nane Nane and Saba Saba before. Why is he doing that? You see, it is something that is called in Kikuyu koharagania. Now that he cannot enter the government, his work is to kuchokora until maybe they reach, maybe he has learned something from Raila. You go and chokora them until they place into the government. But Jimmy Wanjigi does not want to be placed in the government. He wants to be placed in such a way that in the future, contracts he will win. And that is why he financed Saba Saba and Nane Nane. Thank you.